shop when somebody said, "Hey, you, stop!" I looked around. Well, I could see just two little boys standing next to me. He said, "Hey, mama, I've seen you sing, I've seen you dance, and I've seen you swing. Won't you teach me how you do it?" I said, "Achashe, love you, shop boy." Every kid on earth would love to be a superstar. Provides a veritable platform by which our children air their stance on topics related to character development and human capacity building. This program is reaching you from NTA Channel TLVU, of course, your dependable station. In memoriam certified is my name. I am the host of this educative program. Today's motion is English language should be a child's first language. But should that be the ideal case? Very well. Our children, before the coming of the white men, missionaries in the 19th century, our forefathers and mothers taught their children in their local languages. They taught their children how to sweep the floor, greet elders in the morning, how to cook various dishes of different tribes of our country, Nigeria, handicrafts, to mention but a few. This method of learning was called informal education. Okay? Later, the white men, the missionaries, came with the Western education. They encouraged our forefathers and mothers to send their children to the classroom in order to learn how to read and write in English language. This we continue till today. And that method of learning is what we call formal education. What did I say?
Formal education.
First, our motion today is English language should be a child's first language. Very well then, I urge you to sit back, relax, and experience the delight, because today's program is an expository debate. We have some pupils from Full Life International Schools Uyo here to talk on the motion or do justice to the topic. And we have Royal Nesfield International School to cross-examine the Full Life pupils on the motion. So, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to welcome upstate the moderator for today's event, in person of Victory Abasi Freke. Great! Put your hands together for us. Come on,
bring up.
The young shall grow.
Is that right?
Oh yes, the young shall grow.
Hello viewer, you're welcome to this exclusive package of Growing Up. Today's debate is an expository one, and we have pupils from Full Life International Schools to speak on the topic, English language should be a child's first language. To cross-examine them are pupils from Royal Nefsi International Schools. Both schools are located in Akwa Ibom State. Please applaud them. Not forgetting the impartial panel of judges, from my left, I have Mr. William Mbatide, Mrs. Priska Udo, and Mrs. Rosemary Ahim. Starlets,
superstars of tomorrow.
At this point, we take a brief address from the chief judge of the panel.
Growing up,
the young shall grow.
Superstars of tomorrow,
starlets.
All right. I am happy to be here with you today. In this house today, we believe that English language should be the child's first language. What is English language? The school today will do justice just to that. And who are to speak English language? The missionaries brought English language to us in our formal education. But what should we do? Should we use our mother tongue to teach, or should we use English language? What is English language? English language is an internationally accepted language today. So, whatever you have to come and tell us, we will judge. So, we will know from you today, Full Life International School. But what we are going to take into consideration is your appearance, your dressing, the points you dress, the management of your time, your comportment, and your pronunciation as you come up. All that will be taken into consideration. So I wish you the best for today's debate. Please clap for yourself.
Bring up.
The young shall grow.
Bring up.
The young shall grow.
At this point, I invite the timekeeper to give us the time formation. Please listen attentively.
Hello everyone. My name is Gospel Amanda George. This is the time frame. The lead speakers are to speak for 5 minutes, then the first and second supporting speakers will speak for 4 minutes. Then for the reply speech, the lead speakers have 3 minutes each. At the sound of my whistle, point of information begins. When you hear the first bell, it means point of information has ended, and you also have 1 minute to summarize your points. Finally, the second bell. It means your time is up. Please adhere to the time frame. Thank you, and I wish you the best of luck.
Thank you, the timekeeper. Starlets,
superstars of tomorrow.
Thank you. Having heard from the chief judge of the panel and the timekeeper, we kickstart the debate proper as I call on the lead speaker from Full Life International School.
Good day, the moderator, panel of impartial judges, accurate timekeeper, ladies and gentlemen, and my co-debaters. My name is Sin Ernest, and I am here today to uphold the motion that says English language should be the child's first language. Speaking with me today on the opposing side are Edima Omo and Ken Yaka. Before I proceed, permit me to define some terms, language and native language. What is language, if I may ask? Language is a tool of communication used to communicate with each other and also interact socially with other people. Without language, there will be no communication or social interaction. Modern research has identified two different types of language. The native language, L1, and the foreign language, L2. My points are as follows: complex and embarrassing, difficulty and cumbersome, invasion into our privacy, and general communication. Complex and embarrassing. Have you ever noticed how many parents tend to speak to their children in English, mostly in public places? Are they afraid to speak to their children in their native dialect, or do they just want to show the world that they are all so literate because they can just speak some really messy form of it? My point is, the lack of importance we give our language is causing extinction of not only large but important parts. I feel prioritized. Why take pride in speaking a language that is not even your own? Secondly, difficulty of cumbersome. Before one could fully and truthfully say, I understand this language, it would take years and years of learning to fully do so. A great scholar, Daramola, once introduced in one of his books to mass media that the innate ability of a child lies within his nativity and he can acquire it with ease. Hence, I see no reason why English language should be the child's first language. Thirdly, invasion into our privacy. Before the Europeans invaded Africa, or Nigeria to be more precise, in the 19th century, what were we speaking? Wasn't it our native language? Irrespective of our countries, our gender, our ethnicity, and our races, we were all communicating to each other in our native language. Why must we continue to follow the way and lane of our slave masters instead of emancipating ourselves from mental slavery? Fourthly, general communication. My opponent may say that English language is a general means of communication around the world, but let them be reminded that that is not so. In most major countries of the world, like
My name is Divine Emmanuel, a student of World FC International Ships. Point of information, my distinguished colleagues. Has it occurred to you that the poor grammatical construction and wrong expression amongst student speakers of English language in Nigeria can be checkmated if a child is taught the English language at a tender age? Thank you.
That makes English language the child's L1. You see, an L1 is the language you are brought up and raised up in. And that you are brought up and raised up in, and you are expected to know it. It depends on your cultural base, if you are from a foreign country or you are from Nigeria. But in my own defense, I say that is not correct. Your native language should be taught to you as your first language, or the L1. Thank you. In conclusion, I now hope that with these few points of mine, I have been able to convince and not confuse you that English language should not be the child's first language. Thank you.
Thank you. That was wonderful. Let's hear from you, the first supporting speaker.
Good day, the moderator, panel of judges, accurate timekeeper, and co-debaters, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Adima Nimo, a pupil from Full Life International Schools, here to oppose the motion that says English language should be a child's first language, with the following points of mind. First, alienation and disharmony, negligence and pain, hindrance to mother tongue by L2 learning, communication and cultural identity. First, alienation and disharmony. A child is supposed to live among his people relating more to communication. A child who speaks English language to members of his family that do not understand English. Members of his family will be alienated and people will distance themselves from such a child. On this note, therefore, it is pertinent for a child to learn their native language first and not English language. Second, negligence and pain. Speaking of English language as a child's first language is not something we should not allow to continue. The understanding and fluency of a native tongue drastically reduces. For instance, if a child is hurt or injured on the road and keeps up calling for help in English, a lot of people are likely to walk past because they do not understand what the child is speaking. But if he speaks in his native language and is well versed in it, a lot of people are likely to help him. That is why we should learn our native language first and not English language. Third, hindrance to mother tongue by L2 learning. A situation where English is spoken as a child's first language, degradation sets in. The understanding and fluency of our native language drastically reduces. A great linguist, Edimo E., in his book, The Influence of Second Languages Teaching, 2006, states that English language, our native language is being outdated because of the complete use of English language. And this...
Excuse me. Point of information.
I wish to ask, in a country with over 520 indigenous languages and dialects, many of which do not have complete or sufficient vocabularies and phonetic sounds, how do you think a child will do well in the national examinations like WAEC, NECO, JAM, and NATEL, etc.?
That is not what I said. I didn't say that it is wrong for you to learn English language, but I said that you're supposed to learn your native language first before English language. Thank you. As I was saying, hindrance to mother tongue by L2 learning. A great linguist, Edimo E., in his book, The Influence of Second Language in Teaching, states that the native language is getting outdated as a result of complete use of English language. And this situation, I say, is worrisome, and I say should stop. Let us embrace our native dialect as our first language and not English language. Fourth, communication. A child who speaks English language to people who do not understand English, he will not be able to communicate to them freely and express his feelings and emotions. That is why a child should learn his native language first and not English language. Last, cultural identity. One of the most important features of your language is your language. A child who does not know how to speak his language, it will be hard to identify his culture, So a child should learn his native language first and not English language. I hope with these few points of mine, I've been able to convince you that English language should not be a child's first language. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Another round of applause for Happy. We'll go on a short break. We'll be right back.
What a sense of pride. What a fulfillment for every parent when you have a child who is articulate, who speaks logically, and stands out. That's what NTA Channel 12 Uyo wants to achieve with the program Growing Up, so that indeed, as leaders, not just of tomorrow but for today, can start grooming them to be able to speak logically, to be able to gain confidence, which will make them truly our leaders for a better Nigeria. So join the group on NTA Channel 12 Uyo. It's a platform for an articulate and a leader speaker. Join us all the time.
Thanks for being there. It's still Growing Up. Growing Up seeks the sponsorship of kind-hearted individuals and organizations. To sponsor, comment, or contribute to the program, please call the number 080-642-94907. I take the number again, 080-642-94907. You may as well like the Facebook address on your screen. Let's hear from you, the second supporting speaker.
Good day, the moderator, panel of impartial judges, accurate timekeeper, my fellow co-debaters and audience. My name is Kenny Aker, and I'm here to oppose the motion that says English language should be the child's first language with the following points of mind. Point one, for identification. Point two, communicating with uneducated relatives. Point three, passing private information. Point four, on patriotism to Nigeria. For identification, speaking in one's native language helps us to identify one's kinsmen wherever we go. For example, if we are traveling out of the country and we meet someone speaking our native language, we will easily recognize the person and we will be more drawn to the person. Point two, communicating with uneducated relatives. In our society, it could be regarded as arrogance if you respond in English when someone speaks to you in your native language. Therefore, it is important to learn your native language so that you'll be able to communicate effectively with your uneducated relatives. Point three, passing private information. In cases where others don't want people to hear what is being said, parents quickly switch from English language to their native language while speaking to their children. Hence, English language should not be the child's first language. Point four, on patriotism to Nigeria. English language is not our indigenous language, so it would be unpatriotic to learn English instead as our L1 instead of our native language.
Excuse me. My learned colleague, I wish to ask what do you think is responsible for the poor accentuation of today's students. Thank you.
Okay. English language is not our indigenous language, so it would be unpatriotic to learn English as our L1 instead
of... Point of information. My name is Uba Basekono, a student of Rainless International Schools. Again, I wish to ask you, until we make English language a first language of a child, do you think that there will continue to be ethnic crisis and disunity in Nigeria due to tribal consciousness?
I said that English language can also be spoken, but we should learn our native language first so that we'll be able to communicate effectively with our uneducated relatives, because most of our relatives don't really know English language. Thank you. English language is not our indigenous language, so it would be unpatriotic to learn English as our L1 instead of our native languages.
Excuse me. My name is Fawo Fitzgibbon. I'm a pupil of Royal Nation International School. My learned colleague, I wish to ask you, if you oppose English language as the first language instruction, then how then do you address the problem of undue interference between the first language, that is the native language, and the second language, the English language? Thank you.
English language can be spoken. It's just that we should learn our native language first so that we'll be able to
to do our things right. Billy P in his book, Native Languages and Foreign Languages Have Been Embraced. Native Languages and Foreign Languages Usage in Nigeria pointed out that foreign languages have been embraced in schools because Nigeria has historically valued societal bilingualism. To a great extent, we've allowed ourselves to be influenced by this. Our attitudes, our feelings, and beliefs about our L1 has changed. Hence, English language should not be the child's first language. I hope with these few points of mine, I've been able to convince you, not confuse you, that English language should not be the child's first language.
That was sensational. Another round of applause for him. Ballets.
Superstars of tomorrow.
Bring up
the Young Show Group.
At this point, I call on the lead speaker to summarize his points.
Standing on the existing protocol, I, Sinan Ernest, once again wish to oppose the motion that says English language should be the child's first language. Most major countries of the world, such as Russia, Italy, Germany, and Spain, all communicate to each other in their mother tongue. Also, be reminded that English language is a borrowed language and it does not belong to us. So, in such a way, in the process of learning this language, we commit lots and lots of blunders and blemishes that kicks us out of the reach of the received pronunciation of the language owners, the Americans and the Britons. And whereas the native language is developed with innate ability and is acquired easily without effort by a child. So why stretch yourself out in teaching a foreign language to a child instead of teaching him his native language first? So let's let go of ourselves and claim modernization and civilization and start speaking our native language instead of English language as our first language. Thank you.
All those who contributed did extremely well. Let's applaud them, please. At this juncture, I hand it over to the panel of judges for further contributions and announcement of results.
Today's debate has been a very interesting one. Please, can we clap for this comment?
Thank you.
Do you have anything to say?
All right, thank you very much. The children have really done justice to it. We have spoken and I think they have done well. I really want to say this. Yes, English language is very good. There's a means for communicate to one another. But our native language is still very, 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 very important. We should try and see what we can do to teach our children how to speak this language. It will help. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Tell me what to say.
All right. Thank you so much. I am so excited to be here today. I want to thank Full Life International School. The three speakers have done wonderfully well. I want to thank the third speaker. You are a man. Men behave like that. Yes. Even with all the challenges, you were able to land very well. Yes. I love you for that. Thank you for coming. God bless you.
I am impressed by this school. They have told us that English language can be used as a means of communication and a means that we learn in the classroom, not the language that should be taught as a parent to the child as a first language. You know, the first language when you handle a baby like this is what matters a lot because of the environment the child is born. Full Life International School, thank you very much. A round of applause for you. Yeah. Thank you very much, Nefsi International School. You have really cross-examined that topic very well. I am happy because somebody said that your language gives you an identification and make sure that your kinsmen do not pass you by. Thank you very much. I love that. That is a wonderful point which you have given me there. Thank you very much. And in today's debate, we have our best speaker. I don't know whether you know the person I know as the best speaker today. Please clap hand for him. Clap hand for him. Please, a better round of applause for him. Let me tell you what I observed. This person was able to take all the information. 3 points of information for him alone. Clap hand for him. You have been identified as the first speaker for students today. God bless you.
Timekeeper, our moderator, teachers here present, thank you for coming on today's Package of Grain Up. And to our viewer out there, I hope you had a swell time watching today's Package of Grain Up. I hope you've learned a thing or two because I have. Until next week, when we shall be coming your way again with another educative topic, always remember that don't try the tongue mediva in brotherhood with step. So,
be it from Nigeria! Speak your mother tongue!
And from all of us, it's...